it's no doubt that the technology or the mobile technology is going to the broadband much more than current status, like fiber to the cable.
Yeah,
it's much higher speed rather than the ADSL. So it's no doubt to go also in the mobile side as well. So the new technology or new platform can provide a much enriched or a much the new services, new society.
Can we envision LTE to actually give what additional services to mobile users, like I don't know, TV, internet TV?
We could already download 3D videos.
3D videos
using LTE.
And in Japan, you actually have TV, right, on your cell phones.
That's the different technology. We call it one sec.
One sec.
That using the one. This is broadcasting the terrestrial, minimizing the match with the mobile phone. So that is totally different from the LTE technology.
But could LTE technology be adapted also to bring that same kind of service to mobile users, mobile broadband users, to have free TV beamed over to their devices?
That is actually the vision. But however, to be able to bring that here for dominant use, we really need to have the frequency. And that entails government regulation.
Going to the NTC.
Yes,
so you have to apply for a frequency.
But aside from that, there are other things like the devices that we use today. You were mentioning the mobile phones. They also have to be LTE enabled.
So are there devices now that can make use of LTE? I mean, okay, obviously I have an iPad with me. Can this benefit from an LTE network? Not yet.
There are very few devices.
Because it's only 3G enabled. So there are very few devices that are LTE enabled.
At the time of now.
At this time. In Japan, what kind of devices do you have that use LTE?
Originally, we start from the data communication purpose, like now we call the dongle.
The dongle, okay.
Like USB dongle. That will be connected to the PC for a much faster download.
So the dongle is LTE enabled,
yes.
And that's the one that you connect to your device.
Yeah. And with the first edition, of course, later on, the handset type of the gears will be available.
Built in.
Yes,
the LTE feature will be built in. So Glow will have to offer these dongles too.
Well, the dongles that we're offering now, we call it the Tattoo, but right now they're still 3G.
The Tattoo is still 3G.
Yeah.
All right. So it will be upgraded to LTE eventually.
Eventually.
The network, yes, but the devices.
You need a new device. I'm kind of wondering though. So you had two tests already. First in Valero Park, and then you had one here in Quezon City. How many more tests are going to be done?
It's a series of tests. Looking for until 2011. We're still doing some tests.
Until 2011. And the test is to find out exactly if the LTE what signal?
It's more on. We can understand how we can deploy it in the Philippines.
And deploying it means what? Looking for
reliability,
a community or infrastructure within a community that can offer you that kind of conditions, right?
And also the interoperability with the existing network.
Well, the existing networks. You have Globe, of course. You've got Smart. You've got who else? Did I miss out anybody?
The Sun,
of course. Yeah. So everybody has to be in the same, working on the same platform, right? Because that's how 3G also started.
Well, more or less.
Yeah.
Yes.
So but, is it only Globe that's experimenting with it now?
Well, so far that we know, yes, it's only Globe, and we're very excited about it because Globe has long been known for innovation.
So if you're the only one that offers it now, it doesn't matter if the others don't offer it too. I mean, interoperability, it's not going to be a hindrance or an obstacle.
No, what I say interoperability is LTE technology. Anyway, LTE technology, LTE platform, we've connected to the all other Globe network.
The
2G,
the
3G. For 2G, 3G.
So within the same network.
Yes.
All right. So more tests to be carried out. When's the next test going to be?
It's ongoing.
Secret
There's
location?
A series of tests.
Secret location.
No, so test is done by the phases.
Yeah, by the
phases. We start in the laboratory, and now we move to the on the field.
On the outdoor test. So you got Makati and Quezon City. And, and
by the way, Tony, the tests are being done across all the Singtel group-wide companies.
Singtel.
Yes.
Yeah, because that's what Globe is the parent company.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. So you don't want to tell me where the next test is going to be held?
We'll invite you.
You don't want us screwing up your LTE program. Well, thank you very much for coming to the studio. Yoli, Crisanto, Erwin Roque of Globe Telecom, and Takuo Shioda, the president of NEC Philippines. Arigato gozaimasu.
Good thing. Good Japanese.
Oh, of course. Good. Totimo, not warui. Which means very bad. Totimo warui desu. Well, thank you very much for coming to the show.
Enjoyed
learning about LTE from you guys. And thank you for joining us. I'm Tony Velasquez. Join me again next week when we again examine the present and look ahead to the future perfect of Philippine tech.